हाय फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर सतीश एस भोरनारे, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जेनेटिक्स एंड प्लांट ब्रीडिंग, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द टॉपिक सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इन प्लांट्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस सेक्स रेफर्स टू अ कॉन्टेस्टिंग फीचर ऑफ द मेल एंड फीमेल इंडिविजुअल ऑफ द सेम स्पीसीज एंड इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स, मेल सेक्स एंड फीमेल सेक्स। And the sex determination is a process of sex differentiation which utilizes various genetical concepts to decide whether a particular individual will develop into male or female. So this sex determination process determine whether a particular individual will develop into a male sex or a female sex, and the sex is identified with the help of the sex character. And in case of plants, the sex is identified with the male and female floral parts, that is androecium and gynoecium. And here is an overview of all the mechanisms which are found in different plants and animals to determine the sex, in which first is chromosomal system. And this chromosomal system again subdivided into three types, that is allosomal system, diploid haploid system and genic balance system. And here the different animals and plants which have these systems, and among these allosomal system there are four different systems. We can later on see one by one in the detail. We can just here take a overview of these. So this is the first chromosomal system, then second is a monogenic system, and third one is a environmental effect which determine the sex in different plants and animals. Now we can see one by one. First one is a chromosomal sex determination. In plants and animals there are two types of chromosomes. First one is autosomes and second is allosomes. The autosomes are the chromosomes which have no relation with the sex and contain the genes which determine the somatic character of an individuals are known as autosomes. And these chromosomes or these autosomes do not differ in morphology and number in female and male sex. Means that the autosomes are similar in male and female sex. Opposite to that, those chromosomes which differ in morphology and number in male and female sex and contain genes responsible for the determination of sex are known as allosomes or sex chromosomes. And these sex chromosomes were first discovered by scientist McClung in 1902 in Grasshopper, and later on by Wilson and Steven in 1905. So before we go into further, we can differentiate the autosomes and allosomes more clearly. Here the autosomes refer to other than the sex chromosome, while allosomes refers to these chromosomes that are sex chromosomes. And the morphology is similar in male and female sex in case of autosomes, while the allosomes morphology is different in male and female sex. The number is same in both the sexes in case of autosomes, while in case of allosomes the number is sometimes different in male and female sex. Generally the autosomes control the trait other than the sex, while the allosomes usually determine the sex of an individual. The number of autosomes differ from the species to species, while in case of allosomes each diploid organism usually have two allosomes. These autosomes do not exhibit sex linkage, while these allosomes exhibit the sex linkage. In chromosomal system, first is allosomal sex determination system. The allosomes or sex chromosomes are generally X and Y types, but in birds they are of Z and W types. And sex with a similar type of sex chromosome, that is XX or ZZ, is known as होमोगैमेटिक सेक्स. द वर्ड होमोगैमेटिक हैविंग टू वर्ड्स, होमो मीन्स सिमिलर एंड गैमेटिक मीन्स सिमिलर गैमेट्स. सो द होमोगैमेटिक मीन्स दे हैविंग सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ गैमेट्स एंड विथ डिसिमिलर टाइप ऑफ सेक्स क्रोमोजोम, दैट इज एक्स वाई और जेड डब्ल्यू एज अ हेटरोगैमेटिक सेक्स. सो दिस वर्ड इज अ सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी वर्ड. हेटरो मीन्स डिफरेंट, हैविंग डिफरेंट गैमेट्स. एंड इन दैट आलोसोमल सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन देर आर फोर टाइप्स. फर्स्ट वन इज एक्स 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 वाई फीमेल मेल सिस्टम. सेकेंड वन इज एक्स 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 जीरो फीमेल मेल सिस्टम. थर्ड वन इज एक्स जीरो एक्स एक्स फीमेल मेल सिस्टम. एंड फोर्थ वन इज जेड डब्ल्यू जेड जेड फीमेल मेल सिस्टम. सो वी कैन सी वन बाय वन नाउ. फर्स्ट वन इज एक्स 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 वाई फीमेल मेल सिस्टम. दैट मीन्स हियर फीमेल इज एक्स एक्स वाइल मेल इज एक्स वाई. एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ मेल फीमेल सिस्टम इज रिपोर्टेड इन मैन, अदर मैमल्स एंड सर्टन इंसेक्ट्स इंक्लूडिंग ड्रोसोफिला एंड सर्टन एंजियोस्पर्म प्लांट्स इंक्लूडिंग मेलेंड्रियम. इन दिस टाइप ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन सिस्टम द फीमेल्स पजेसेस टू एक्स क्रोमोसोम, दैट इज एक्स एक्स एंड दस होमोगैमेटिक एंड होमोमॉर्फिक, वाइल द मेल्स पजेसेस वन एक्स एंड वन वाई क्रोमोसोम, दैट इज एक्स वाई एंड आर हेंस हेटरोगैमेटिक एंड हेटरोमॉर्फिक. व्हेन एन एग इज फर्टिलाइज्ड बाय वाई बियरिंग स्पर्म द मेल इज प्रोड्यूस्ड, दैट मीन्स द वाई क्रोमोसोम हैविंग जीन्स फॉर मेलनेस. वी कैन सी इन द डायग्राम ऑल्सो द फीमेल इज होमोगैमेटिक हैविंग ऑटोसोम्स, टू सेट्स ऑफ ऑटोसोम्स एंड टू एक्स क्रोमोसोम, वाइल मेल इज हेटरोगैमेटिक हैविंग टू सेट्स ऑफ ऑटोसोम्स एंड एक्स एंड वाई क्रोमोसोम. दैट्स वाई प्रोड्यूस टू गैमेट्स, वन इज विथ एक्स एंड वन इज विथ वाई एंड द प्रोजेनीज आर एज गिवन इन द डायग्राम हैविंग बोथ 50-50%, दैट इज फीमेल एंड मेल. सो दिस इज द एक्स 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 वाई फीमेल मेल सिस्टम. This system is also reported in some plants like melandrium, and these plants also having pistillate plants and staminate plants. Pistillate means female and staminate means the male. These pistillate plants is of XX type, XX chromosome, and the staminate plant having XY chromosome. And in this plant, the single dose of Y is able to produce a male sex even presence of a 4X chromosome. That means the Y is determining the maleness. The detailed investigation of the sex chromosome of melandrium plant revealed that the Y chromosome has four regions. First one is a male suppression region, second one is a male promotion region, third one is a male fertility region, and fourth one is a pairing region, and which is common in X and Y chromosome. We can see in diagram also. And if the first region is lost, a bisexual plant is produced, and when the second region is lost, female plant is produced, and when third region is lost, male sterile plant with abortive anthers are developed. So this is the sex determination in the plants melandrium. Okay, now this second type is XXX0 female male system. In certain insects belonging to order Hemiptera, that is true bugs, Orthoptera, that is grasshopper, and Dictyoptera, that is cockroaches, female has 2X chromosomes, that is XX, that means they are homogametic, while male has a single X copy in its single X copy of chromosomes. That's why they are heterogametic and produces two types of sperm, half with X chromosome and half without X chromosome in an equal proportion. We can see in diagram also the female is homogametic, producing a single gamete A plus X, while the male is a heterogametic, producing two types of gamete, one is with X and one is without X chromosome, and the progenies is as like below, the 50-50% female and male. next one is X0, XX female male system, which is opposite to the earlier system we have studied recently. This system has been reported in very few species of the insect like Phemia. In this case, the male has two X chromosomes, that is XX, that means male is homogametic, while female has only single X chromosome and is heterogametic, and thus the sex of the progeny is depend upon kind of the egg produced by the female, and this system has not been reported in plants so far. Last system is ZWZZ female male system. This system is found in birds, butterflies and moths. In this system, female is heterogametic and produce two types of gamete, one is with Z chromosome and other with W chromosome. On the other hand, male is heterogametic and produces all the sperm of the same type carrying Z chromosome. We can see in the diagram also, thus the sex of offspring depend on the kind of egg being fertilized by the male. The Z chromosome bearing eggs produces male, but the W chromosome bearing egg produces female. So another type of the system besides this chromosomal system is diploid haploid female male system, and it is very common in the insects like ant, bees, wasp, and in honeybee also. And in this honeybee, the queens usually mates only once during its lifetime, and the sex ratio of offspring is under the control of queen, and fertilized egg develop into diploid female, and those egg which the queen chooses not to be fertilized develop parthogenetically into a haploid but fertile males, that is drones. Most of the eggs laid in the hive will be fertilized and develop into a worker females. So friends, in case of this honeybee, there are two types of female. One is queen, which is diploid, and another one is workers. They are also females, but they are sterile. And during investigation, it has been found that the quantity and quality of food available in the diploid larvae determines whether a female will become a sterile worker or fertile queen. The diploid larva which feed on royal jelly develops into a fertile female called queen, and remaining larvae gives rise to workers which are sterile females. So this is the very beautiful case of the diploid haploid system. In this system, female is a diploid one, that is mostly queen, while remaining females which are sterile are worker and haploid, while male is always fertile but haploid and called as a drone. Then third one, that is genic balance system. The genic balance mechanism of a determination of a sex was first observed and studied by the scientist C.B. Bridges in 1921, and it is also known as Bridges theory of the sex determination. While working with Drosophila, and for the inheritance of vermilion eye color in Drosophila. So this C.B. Bridges, while working with Drosophila eye, that is vermilion eye color, found this theory, that is genic balance theory, or the genic balance theory or system of sex determination. According to this mechanism, the sex of an individual in Drosophila melanogaster is determined by a balance between the genes for the femaleness located in the X chromosome and those for the maleness located in the autosomes. So friends, according to this theory, not only sex chromosome but also autosomes have a role in a sex determination, and this can be proven by the C.B. Bridges in Drosophila. And hence, the sex of an individual is determined by the ratio of number of X chromosome and that of its autosomal set, the Y chromosome being unimportant. That means we now, up till now, that studied that the Y is important for maleness, but according to this theory, the number of X chromosome and autosome sets are having role in determining the sex. The ratio is termed as a sex ratio and is expressed as follows. The sex ratio is equal to number of X chromosome, that is X, and number of autosomal sets, that is A. So the sex index is equal to X by A. And here the different doses of X chromosome and autosome sets and their effect on the sex determination. So this is the outcome or the results of the Bridges experiment, and we can see over here at the last column that sex expression, when the sex index is 0.5, the individual is male. When it is 1, it is a female. When it is above the 1, it is a super female. When it is between 0.5 and 1, it is intersex, and when it is between below the 0.5, it is super male or meta males. So friends, this sex ratio is nothing but the number of X chromosome upon autosomes, and here is the clear cut result which showing that for determination of sex in case of Drosophila, this sex ratio play an important role. Only when this sex index or sex ratio is 1, the female individual is female, and when only it is 0.5, the male individual is produced. This super female or meta female, or super male or meta male, are not superior, but they are sterile or inviable also. So from this experimental data we can confirm that in case of Drosophila, the sex is determined by the sex ratio, and according to this Bridges, this is the case of sex determination in Drosophila, and that's why they called it as a genic balance theory, in which number of autosomes and allosomes play a equal role in sex determination. Then second type of the sex determination is monogenic sex determination. This mono means single genic, single genes are responsible for sex determination, and this is reported in Neurospora, Asparagus, Drosophila, maize, and it is influenced by the differential action of a single autosomal gene which overrules the effect of the same chromosome present in the individual. So autosomal recessive transformer TRA gene of a Drosophila. So it is an example of that monogenic sex determination. In case of Drosophila, there is a single transformer gene, autosomal recessive gene, that is TRA. When it is present in homozygous recessive state, that is TRA, it transform the female, that is XX, the female is homogametic in case of Drosophila, zygote, to develop into a male which is sterile. The gene TRA is recessive and hence does not have any effect in heterozygous condition, that is TRA. When it is a heterozygous condition, there is no any effect on either sex, that is male or female. In homozygous condition, this gene has no effect in male, but as we see earlier, when this is a homozygous condition, in case of female, it transfer this female into a male gamete. So this is the single gene TRA responsible in Drosophila to transfer the sex or determine the sex. The monogenic control of the sex has been also reported in some plants like asparagus. This asparagus plant is a dioecious plant, and dioecious having the male and female flower or plant is different, means one plant is having only male flower and another plant is having only female flower. So this is the dioecious plant. However, rarely female flowers bears rudimentary anthers and male flowers bear the rudimentary pistils, and occasionally these male flowers with poorly developed pistils set seed on shelving and segregate in 3:1 ratio of a male and female, and segregation of the sex in seed obtained from the rare bisexual flower in the asparagus showing monogenic control. We can see in the diagram also where these rare male plant, when self produce the male and female in 3:1 ratio. That means when a 3:1 segregate ratio is obtained, the plants or the individuals undergoing the crossing is having a single gene difference or governed by the single genes. That's why we can confirm here the single gene is governing this sex in this asparagus. And another example of this monogenic sex determination is a maize. So friends, this maize is a monoecious, means having both male and female flower on the same plant. We can see in the diagram also the male flower is called male in flower or inflorescence is called as tassel in case of maize, while female inflorescence called as cob or ear or a silk, and it is present on the same plant. That's why it is a monoecious. A recessive gene called as BA, that is barren cob, in homozygous condition, that is BABA, makes a cob barren and non-functional. So friends, this is the another type of gene, BA gene, that is barren cob gene. When it is in a homozygous condition, produce the cob barren and non-functional. Cob is a female part, cob means cob is a female part. Similarly, a recessive gene, another recessive gene is there in maize, TS gene, in homozygous condition, that is small ts, convert the male flower into a tassel, male flowers of the tassel into the female flower. So another recessive gene, that is TS, the single gene convert the male flower tassel into the female flower's silk or cob, and thus homozygous state of the gene BABA convert the monoecious plant into the male plant or a staminate plant. Similarly, the gene TS in homozygous condition, that is small ts, convert the monoecious plant into a female, that is pistillate plant. So these two genes bear important role in case of maize. A single gene can convert this monoecious plant into a staminate or a pistillate. And the plants with both dominant genes, that is BA indominant and TS indominant, are monoecious, while with both BABA and TS normal male, with BA and small ts, that is female, and with both BABA ts, it is a rudimentary female. So friends, these two genes are important in case of maize. So it can produce all types of plant, monoecious, female, male, or rudimentary female. So in case of male, the sex determination is under the control of these two genes, that is TS and BA. Another example, interesting example of this monogenic sex determination is papaya. In papaya, the sex is postulated to be governed by three alleles of the same gene, and these three alleles are small m, capital M1 and capital M2. These three alleles of a single gene, when homozygous recessive, that is small m, produces female plants, heterozygous, that is M1 means when this homozygous recessive MM, these genes is homozygous condition, produces a female plant. And heterozygous, that is capital M2 produces male and hermaphrodite plants respectively. That means capital M1 produces male plant and capital M2 produces hermaphrodite plants in case of papaya. However, the combination of both dominant allele, that is capital M1 and capital M2, produces inviable plants both in homozygous, that is M1 and M2, and heterozygous conditions. So friends, these two alleles, these two alleles and combination of this dominant allele always produces inviable plants, either in homozygous condition or heterozygous condition. And when we took a cross between female, that is small m small m, and male, that is m1m, produces a female and male in a 1:1 ratio. Similarly, a cross between female, that is small m small m, and hermaphrodite, that is hermaphrodite means having hermaphrodite flower means plants means bisexual flower having both male and female. So hermaphrodite m2m will produce females mm and hermaphrodite in 1:1 ratio. So friends, before we going to complexity, we can see here the single gene control the type of sex in papaya. Papaya is a famous example of a dioecious plant, means in case of papaya there is a single plant is having only male or another plant is having female. So this single gene and having three different alleles which produces different types of the sex in papaya. And when we selfing of hermaphrodite, that is m2m plants produces hermaphrodite and female progeny is 2:1 ratio, and about 1/4 of the zygotes, that is m2 do not survive. So friends, from this example we can clearly say that the papaya is having monogenic sex determination. And last one is the environmental sex determination system. In many reptiles, sex determination is by environmental factor like temperature. In most of the turtle species, only females are produced at the high temperature, that is 30 to 35 degrees Celsius, while only males are produced at low temperature, that is 23 to 28 degrees Celsius. So friends, this turtle is under the control of environmental for the sex determination. And main the temperature, when there is higher temperature, only females are produced, and lower the temperature, only males are produced. Sex ratio changes suddenly from all males to all female with just changes in temperature of 2 degrees Celsius during the incubation. Means the temperature is a play vital role in determination of sex in case of turtle species. In crocodile and lizard also, the males are produced at higher temperature while females are produced at lower temperature, which is reverse to the turtle species. And in Bonellia viridis, a marine worm, all larvae are genetically and cytologically similar. If a particular larva settles near the proboscis of adult female, it becomes a male individual, and if this larva develops freely in water, it becomes a female. So this is the case in Bonellia worm. If it is free, then this larvae free in water, this if larvae develops freely in water, it becomes a female. And if it is if it is larvae near to proboscis of adult female, it becomes a male individual. And in some plants also, sex determination is depend on the day length, temperatures and hormones. And for example, in case of cucumber, that is cucumis sativa, and muskmelon, treatment with ethylene enhances the production of female flowers. So this is the case of a plant in which the environment play important role in determination of sex. When we utilize the ethylene, the more number of female flowers is produced in most of the cucumbers and muskmelon. So this video is for education purpose only. References are as below. Thanks for watching.